welcome back to a little bit of Calm and Crazy. My name is Jennifer, and today I have three Dollar Tree spring decor ideas for you. They are perfect for your front porch or your back patio. I'm super excited because today's video is in collab with Courtney over on Creative on the Cheap. If you have not been to her channel, you absolutely need to go check her out. She is super creative and you will love her DIYs. Not only is Courtney very creative and gives some really great DIYs, but she gives really great explanations and explains her DIYs very well, but she also gives you some really good alternatives as she goes through her DIYs. So make sure that you head over there and you check out her three DIYs and let her know that I sent you by putting a little scissor emoji in her comments. If you're coming over from Courtney's channel, hello and welcome. I am so glad that you are here. I hope you take a moment and introduce yourself in the comments below. If you are returning, I'm glad that you are back. I hope that you are enjoying yourself and I hope that you enjoy these DIYs as well. I would love it if you would stick around and subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos. If you don't know it, you can follow me on Instagram. It's a little bit of Calm and Crazy over there, just like it is here. So one tip that I have for you that I was not able to show you because it was raining here in Texas is that you should seal your wood if you are gonna be putting these outside. So the sealant that I used is just the Rust-Oleum. This is a matte clear enamel one. This I just picked up at Walmart, so this isn't necessarily anything special. And you do want to use this outside, and that's why I was not able to do it because it was raining here. And just like any sort of spray paint or anything like that, you just do a nice thin layer over it to protect it, and that will keep it protected from the elements. That's the only tip I have for you, so let's go ahead and head right on into these projects. For the first project, I will be using three of these shadow style boxes as well as one set of the mini clay pots. I also will be using these cute little mums. These came from Walmart and I'm using three sets of those. These were only 97 cents. To begin with, I just take my craft knife around the box and the edges and I just score and I just go around trying to loosen up as much as I can. And after I get it all scored on the front side, I will even flip it over and I can score on the back side. Now, each box is a little different on how it's holding on and how much and where exactly you need to score. And so I just kind of play around in the areas that it needs it and I score in different areas. As you do that, you'll see that it will pop off. You will have a little extra paper in areas and don't worry about that. We'll go back to that in a minute. Do the exact same process with the next two boxes. After that, go ahead and remove the little hanging part. It quickly just will pop out. You can unscrew it if you want to, but they really honestly just pop out. And then you want to go in and remove any of the excess paper that you can. You don't have to be perfect about this, but you do want to remove as much as you can, because we will be painting the back side of this. In my case, this is sitting on my table outside and you can see my table from inside, and so I really want this to have a 360 view. After that, I went in with Waverly's chalk paint and plaster and I painted the back side. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. I just wanted to cover up that boxy cardboard look so that it would have a great 360 view, so that no matter what side you looked at, it would seem like a finished product. Once your paint has dried, you want to go in with some wood glue. I'm using Gorilla, and place a little bit of glue on one of your boxes. Here I have chosen to do it at an angle. You can go at an angle or you can stack them straight. Going in with some wood clamps. Again, this is a choice or an option. If you don't have wood clamps, you can just stack them and the glue will dry. This just makes it a little bit extra secure. So if you are going at an angle, I would choose to go at an opposite angle with the top box. And again, using another wood clamp at that top box. You do want to let the glue have enough time to completely set up. So let it go ahead and rest, I would say overnight, and then come back to it the next day. Going in with some E6000 and taking the mini clay pots. I am stacking one clay pot on each one of the little boxes. And again, giving this plenty of time to set up and dry. Because this is a little bit wobbly, I am placing some wood around it to make sure it does not fall over as that E6000 sets up.
To fix my wobbly problem, I'm taking this tumbling tower game and three pieces of that, and I paint them in the Waverly chalk paint and plaster. Once that is all dried, I go in again with my Gorilla wood glue and I secure that to the base of my little planting tower, and that will take care of my wobbling issue. Again, just set it aside and give time for the glue to set up. So I ended up doing a little touch up and decided to go ahead and change the paint color to a white acrylic paint because the plaster was a little too yellow undertoned, and so I preferred a white acrylic instead. Finally, after letting the paint dry, now we can finish out this project. Now take a small piece of floral foam and make sure that they are nice and secure inside each one of the floral pots. You need to then cut your flowers so that you can stick them inside of your pots. If you're going with the mums, I chose to use 5 mums per pot, so a total of 15. You can also, of course, choose flowers from the Dollar Tree if you want to, and of course, choose any colors that you prefer. Now, I decided after I first put my mums in that I wanted to go back and cut them shorter. You will see that because I didn't want to use any sort of moss or anything. I wanted my mums to actually cover up the floral foam and the rim of my pots. And so I decided to go ahead on the second cut and make my mums shorter. So that's something to think about. If you don't want to have anything else in your pot, you might want to go ahead and cut them shorter so that they are in your pot shorter. I hope that makes some sense, and you'll see that as I go along. So kind of think about that. So for this, I needed a total of 15 flowers. And again, because I wanted this to have a beautiful 360 view, I wanted it to be full on the front as well as on the back. And so I put one flower in the center, and then I had the one flower on each one of the corners, and that's why I needed 5 flowers per pot. I just love how this turned out. I just think it's so simple yet so beautiful. Project number 2 really is just the perfect tie-in. So again, a little bit more E6000. And this is the larger of the clay pots. This comes in the pack of 2. You will also need the glass cutting board that you get in the kitchen section at the Dollar Tree. So all I did for this was I took a little bit of the E6000 and placed it around the rim of the clay pot, and then place the glass cutting board just right on top and put it right into the center. It is as simple as that, and I just love it. I can't tell you how many times I went back and forth on if I wanted to paint it or not, and in the end, I decided to keep it simple, and for this, I thought simple was best. I would love to hear what you think, so leave me a comment below. For the last project, I grabbed this Somebody Loves You sign. This is left over from Easter. Honestly, you could use any of the Dollar Tree signs that you may have on hand, or grab one that you can still find in the stores. Some of the wooden letters, you just will need one package of these. You will also need some white acrylic paint as well as some black acrylic paint. Now this is optional, but I will be using some contact paper to cover up the back of the sign to give it that finished polished look for that 360 appearance that I am going for. And so if you want to have that too, you will need some contact paper. First, go ahead and remove the little metal, corrugated metal from the front of the sign. We will not be using that in any of the projects for this, but I am saving them because I know that I will use those in a future project. So always keep your little scraps because they can come in handy. After that, you are going to go in with some wood filler. This did come from the Dollar Tree, and fill in the tiny little holes that you have after removing the string that was used in order to hang the sign. You do need to give that some time to set up and dry, but once it does set up and dry, you do go in with just a light sandpaper and sand that flat. And then after you have sanded that, you can go in and you will paint it with your white acrylic paint. All I did was use one coat of the acrylic paint. I was okay with a little bit of that backing showing through. Now, as you saw that, I already had the letters painted for grow and planted, which I pulled out. Now, here I will be doing grow where you are planted. You also could choose to do bloom where you are planted, but I only wanted to use one pack of letters and I only have one O, so that is why I chose to use the word grow. But of course, do whatever you want. So going in with that same white acrylic paint, I painted the words grow and planted. I also painted one paint stick that I get in a pack of 10 from Home Depot. The entire pack is just under a dollar, and I love to have these on my hand at all times. They come in so handy. And so I got all of those painted and I let them set aside and dry before I moved on to the next step. Once my paint on my sign was dry, I went ahead and I took my contact paper and I traced it out kind of loosely because I can always trim it up in the end. I just wanted to get a nice tracing so I knew exactly generally the idea of what I wanted and where I wanted it placed. And once I had it traced out, I went ahead and I cut out my tracing and then I placed my contact paper onto the back, just peeling off a little bit at a time and placing it on, trying to avoid any bubbling as I went. And the nice thing is that if you do make a little mistake, you can kind of pull it up and place it back down. Once I had it on to my sign, I did go back in with my craft knife and I did trim up the edges and get off any of the extra that was hanging over on the sides to make it nice and clean. And I just really like the finished polished look that this gave the back of my sign. Now, taking a straight edge of any kind, using a Sharpie, draw a straight line from one side to the other, creating a faux shiplac look. You will do this twice so that you will have three different boards going vertically along your sign. I am using the backing of my contact paper and I am freehanding where you are and scribbling onto the back in order to create a tracing paper for the where you are in order to place that onto my sign. So I have scribbled it all out. Now I am placing this onto my sign where I want it, and once I get it where I want it, then you go over it with your pencil or anything, it doesn't have to be a pencil, and you trace back over it, and that will leave the print onto your sign so that you can then go over it with a Sharpie so that you can leave it on there permanently. After you go over it with a Sharpie, which I did have to do twice, erase any extra pencil marks that you have. This will work just as well with a printed font, not just a handwritten font. And there you have it, such an easy way to get the font that you want. I'm sorry, but somehow I lost the footage of me dry brushing with black acrylic paint onto the sign as well as onto the letters for grow and planted. I just took the black acrylic paint, I dabbed off as much of the acrylic paint as I could, and then took it along the edges, and then I also dabbed it all around the edges of the letters, allowing, of course, it to get into the center of it and making sure that most of it still was on the edges and covering up quite a bit of the white acrylic paint on the letters because I did want the letters to pop off of the white of the board, but I still wanted that white to pop through. After that, I went in with my wood glue and I glued the letters down and I let that dry. Once those letters sat and dried, I went ahead and I took my paint stick and I used hot glue as well as some E6000 and I glued that to the back of the sign. And then once that set and dry, it was now time to place it into my little galvanized bucket. In order to keep that inside, I am going in with some rocks. Now, I do have some of these rocks that I've had laying around. My kids painted. It doesn't matter what rocks you used. I did want to top it off with some nice shiny black rocks that I got from the Dollar Tree. So I filled it in with some of my older rocks on the bottom, topped it with some of my shiny black rocks on top. And there you have it. I felt like it turned out perfectly and I love this. I love how all three of these projects came together and how all three look sitting next to each other. I would love to know what you think. Which one of these do you love the most? Do you love how they all look together? Would you only pick one of these? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget, if you have not hit that subscribe button, make sure that you do. If you enjoy this video, please give it a big thumbs up. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.